Hello, Sir Bertie Bertram Anastasia Bumblebee Legohead here. And I'm welcoming you to this video. I don't know why, we don't know what we're going to call it yet. I say we, I really don't care. He's even got me a background look. Shame the apple's in the way. I could use an apple. Well, I haven't had breakfast yet. Make me some breakfast! Anyway, you may have noticed that there's a bit of a countdown on the website. Starting at 10. And this is day 10. Being a countdown, it's going to go down. So tomorrow will be day 9. Oh, steady on. You take over. I'm bored of this. Testicles now. You're an idiot. Oh, here we go. So anyway, I'm in DHL in Malask. DHL standing for Dust Haulage und Logistik in German, of course. Yes, day 10. So this is day 10. On day 0, I hope this goes well. I hope something. Well, you're going to see this. It's not going to be a big giveaway. Well, me saying this, something needs to arrive on time for this countdown to work. And I'm told it will arrive probably be tomorrow when I put this video up. So it'll probably be arriving tomorrow, so I'll put this video up the day before it arrives. So yeah, so I need things to fall into place. And you know what transport's like, they don't normally fall into place. Please fall into place. So yeah, I need something to arrive on time for the countdown to work. Otherwise it's all going to look like a load of old bollocks. Excuse the swearing. So, yeah, I'm in Belfast or thereabouts, heading up to Londonderry now, which is quite interesting. I very rarely get up that sort of way to load some frozen goods. DHL in Malask. Not a bad place, but everybody seems to have had their personality removed. I don't think that's being too nasty, is it? They just don't seem very, charismatic. I think wanting people in a warehouse to be charismatic, though, is a bit much to ask. So, yeah, we'll do a couple of minutes each day sort of thing. And then what will happen is, like I say, we'll have this video doing the countdown. And then on day 0, we'll have a single video and you'll see what this is about. It's exciting, trust me. Well, it's exciting for me. Right. Bertie?
What?
Cheer up. Make me a cup of tea. Right, finally been MTI'd. Shut up. While I'm charging the camera, I can't listen to my digital radio because I don't have one socket and I do blah 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 blah. And I've been listening to you and yours. Jesus Christ, that program is so boring. But then I'm not really into money and stuff.
I could save 20 pence.
I'm having a banana for lunch.
Right. Onward! Sorry, mouthful. Onward! Oh, and we're off. Fridge is on because the load is frozen, so it's always a good idea to pre-cool the fridge. Frozen loads. It's 78 kilometres. We're not going to Londonderry, we're going to Coleraine. 78 kilometres. Don't know what that is in miles, I neither know nor care. I'm very much a man of the metric age. Get out of my way. Come on! Move, man! Oh, I take it back. There's an inconsiderate man stopped in an inconsiderate place on the road. The colour driver has done nothing wrong. Oh, sick music.
Expenses that he was expecting.
No, no!
Nah. Need somebody to help me sing.
I'm here.
Yay.
Ballyrushian Creamery. Just on the bay. They're working on already. They don't hang around, do they? Weather is somewhat inclement. My legs ache for some reason. Right, Bertie. What's the matter? I can't swear. I hate you. So there we go. I'm gonna have a nap now, because I'm knackered.
Boom! Loaded 22 pallets in 19 minutes. Which is quite impressive, isn't it? Out my way. On my way where, I don't know. All I've got is a small collection note with no address on it anyway, so. Could be going to Ireland, could be going to the UK, could be getting on a ferry, might not be getting on a ferry. Just waiting for some sort of confirmation from the office. So on and so forth. Good day to you all. I think I've pointed this out in a video before. Six Music, yay! They're playing one of the best songs ever made. In my opinion. As I walk on supposed golden path, I was confronted by a mysterious... 10 points if you can name the singer. Big morning to the graveyard. Over on yonder hill, my pause in cosmic reflection. Let's count a couple of those in Flaming Lips, Golden Path. We still want your change suggestion.
Bastard! Sorry, I shouldn't swear. You can't interrupt that song! Damn it!
Babies by the tin.
Right, so heading to Dublin.
Just had a nice snooze and a bowl of booze this to sustain me. Took one for dinner this evening. I imagine the sister in a boat out of Belfast. It's a bit oversubscribed, so I'm shipping Irish Ferries instead. Got Whitchurch for 11 a.m. tomorrow, so not too taxing. That bloody muesli is sitting at the bottom of my stomach. It makes me feel like I've got a load of lead in there. Damn it! Get out of my way! Yes. I'm overtaking you. Slow down. Once the sat nav sorted itself out, I'll tell you how far we've got to go. 2 hours and 46 minutes. 29 kilometres. Might have to go into Dublin Yard and get some fuel, I don't know. Make that decision as we get closer. Onward!
Does anybody know what fucking cruise control is? Catching that lorry up for ages and ages and ages and ages, bit by bit, and I thought, right, I'll just pull out and overtake him now. And then he speeds up! Jesus Christ! Bloody hell. Standard of lorry driving is plummeting. That's all I'm going to tell the matter. You watch, I better slow down again shortly, and then I'll pull out to overtake him, then he'll speed up again. A lot of them are as bad as idiot car drivers.
What does that sign mean? Q synonym BP. Is there a BP in a place called Sydenham, and are we all queuing for that? Q Sydenham BP. Q Sydenham. I'm gonna stop thinking about that. It's melting my brain. We're in a queue anyway, and it's got something to do with Sydenham BP. As you were. New Rolling Stones. I think this song is amazing.
this is Finglas, one of Dublin's more affluent areas, land of dogs on strings and horses in gardens, North Dublin. Just heading into the yard now. A lot of drivers think I'm mad for going this way, but the other way is no way, no better. And the other way, the road often gets absolutely plastered in crap, so you get a dirty lorry. So I come through the middle of a town. So yeah, just gonna nip into the yard, fill up with fuel, pop, drop some paperwork off, give the lorry a quick blast over the pressure washer because it's a bit grubby, and shoot down to Irish Ferries. Onward, boom! See what I said about horses? And there's a horse. Can you, I'm not sure you can see it. Oh yes, you can. There's loads of horses in Finglas. They often actually, there's a greenery over there, and you'll often see them in there eating grass. How exciting! I'm the first one on the boat. Can't remember how to get to the boat. There's the boat! I might go upstairs to the driver's restaurant and then see what the food's like up there. I haven't been up there for donkey's years. Do they still serve food up there? Well, we're about to find out. Onward! Right, so here we are in Holyhead. It's 0034. I was originally booked on P&O, and when he said Irish Ferries, I think, oh no. Mainly because I hate Irish Ferries. But actually, it works out better because now I get to have a good 6.5-7 hours solid sleep and get up at a nice. I can actually get up at 8 o'clock, actually, because I'm not booked until 11. Whereas on the P&O, you're woken up at half 4. So, yeah, I don't go to sleep on the Irish Ferries or Stena either at that time of night, because it's pointless. So I'm going to go down the road, find a lay-by, and go to Biddy-Bys. Bedwood! That sounds remarkably like Jedwood, doesn't it? Jedwood! I actually like Jedwood, I think they're hilarious. Bye! Oh, there's my favourite ship ever, ferry ever. I don't know how much longer it'll be running. That only runs into summer now anyway, doesn't it? I love that boat. I think it's amazing. It is a feat of magnificent engineering. Unfortunately, the world is getting slower and slower and slower. You got all these houses lined up alongside Holyhead. I have no idea how they put up with it. All this noise.
Right, just having a lot of breakfast, listening to Michael Heseltine on the radio. Of course, like Michael Heseltine.
And secondly,
this interview makes me like him even more.
This government has done, and
he's a really interesting bloke.
There's breakfast. And that is the case. Yeah. Egg and bacon.
And had a cup of tea.
I wonder whether there isn't going to be a.
I'm going to eat that now, and then continue my journey.
Kick a lot of this into the long.
Well, it's a lovely day.
Welcome to beautiful Anglesey. Land of your dreams. Bloody hell. I just tried to open the window to do my hair in the mirror and I got blown away. Right, off to Whitchurch, I suppose.
Right, they've redesigned this junction. You see, I'm in the wrong lane now. They've redesigned this junction on the A41. Oh, go! Oh, for fuck's sake. God, you made that difficult. And it's quite startlingly the worst. Oh, it's just awful. It is absolutely a disgrace. The road designer that designed this junction wants to be shot at dawn! It might be a bit extreme, but it is really badly designed as anybody else. It's just amazing how badly they've done it. I've never seen anything like it. Oh well. It really pisses me off. Here we are, we're launching into another round. The state in which farmers leave these fucking roads. If that was a quarry or a tip, it would need a wheel wash. Yet farmers are allowed to scatter shit all over the roads constantly without a care in the world. Not to mention the fact it turns them into a bloody skating rink. My lorry, which was previously clean about 5 minutes ago, now looks like I've just driven it through a bloody field.
bloody fucking idiots. Ah, so fucking annoying.
Right, so just waiting to tip in Grow Continental. They've got new lorries. Two drivers in the office there just talking about them. Grow Continental. Don't stop there. Quite nice, aren't they? But they were hoping to blow a pair of buggers. Anyway, I'm going to make a cup of tea. Onward!
Day in the woods, set baby some wood.
I love Divine Comedy, one of the most intelligent, cleverest bands ever. I say bands, it's just Neil Hannon, isn't it? Basically. Anyway.
Shopping! Asda!
Then swap trailers, then to port. We've got to start rattling through these videos, this is going to be hours long. Boom!
The weather is becoming clement! Right, I changed trailers. Now heading back up to Holyhead. I've got wind. Back up to Holyhead, 2130 Stena boat. So a bit of a shower, a bit of dinner, a bit of reading. Up to 8 in the morning, well no, about midnight, park in Stena in Dublin, and then got a delivery tomorrow in Ireland somewhere, and so on and so forth. So I bid you good day. Good day to you.
So, I'm in Holyhead, and it's Halloween. Should have just remembered. Bert is getting into the swing of things. What do you mean I'm getting into the swing of things? You've done it again, haven't you? Haven't you? I knew I shouldn't have gone to sleep. You've drawn all over my face. I'm sorry, Bertie. I just couldn't resist. What have you done this time? You've just got some fangs. Get off my mouth. Wipe them off. Oh, dear. Oh, you stupid man. Let me go out trick-or-treating. I won't headbutt a child. They could fill my head with sweets. I have to remove your condiments first, though. So there we have it. Vampire Bertie. Vampire Bertram Benedict Anastasia Bumblebee Lego Head. So yes, onto the boat to have some food. Blah 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 blah.
Hi.
See you tomorrow. Right, so day 8. In the countdown, yes, I'm combing my hair with a fork because I can't find my comb again. I go through them like they're going out of fashion. Anyway, being a man of extreme luxury and opulence, I'm having a steak for breakfast. The actual reason being it's Thursday, and I'm going to visit some mates in Bristol at the weekend, so that I won't get a chance to eat it otherwise.
One steak, where's mine?
Having a pork chop.
Why is it not cooked yet?
Because you're having it later. And an egg. Steak, mushrooms, and egg.
Tasty.
I'm parked in Stena. There we are, Luke's top tip. Can't see because the windows are all misted up. If you're on the Stena boat, you can come off. Go out the gate and then come back in again as we're booking on. You can park inside. Just tell them you've been on the boat.
Onward!
Right, I'm loaded. Didn't swap trailers in the end, I had to load this one. And are in Cavan, and now on my way to Dublin for the 4 o'clock boat. Sorry, I thought I pressed the button then and stopped the doodle. Rather lovely lady receptionist in this place in Cavan. Quite a fine looking woman too. I must say.
You'd like her, Bertie. Quick, take me in there!
Right, off we go.
Shoot on down to the boat. Got to go and get some fuel first as well, in the yard.
Mayday! Mayday!
There's enough flashing lights in there. Oh, it's busy, 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 busy. That was really camp, wasn't it?
Oh dear, I'm quite tired.
Oh, the queue's massive now.
Cheers.